Okay, now we go to the next subtopic, which is the semi-synthetic polymer. Okay, as I mentioned before, semi-synthetic polymer means that it is derived from the naturally occurring biopolymer. It's either regenerated or reformulated. Regenerated means that you have the original biopolymer. Okay. In certain condition means, for example, it's already been used to make product A, and then you regenerate that biopolymer to make product B. Okay, means that the original chemical structure in the beginning will be the same with the last output. The only difference that in the process of making regenerated semi-synthetic polymer, there are chemical reactions involved, but in the end, the reacted or the resulting product will be having a chemical structure as the beginning. Okay, the chemical reaction in the middle is used to change the physical properties and also the quality of the fiber. For example, over here we have a rayon. Rayon is a regenerated cellulose fiber. Okay, it is composed of regenerated cellulose, whereby the substituent of the hydrogen, okay, in the hydroxyl group is replaced by 15%. It is small replacement. That's why, and at the end of the resulting product, the chemical structure is almost the same. When producing rayon, okay, rayon is a type of cloth, okay, that is used largely during 70s and 80s. Okay, when you are doing when you are producing rayon, the purified cellulose is converted to a soluble compound. Okay, when this is the conversion, okay, it is regenerated into almost pure cellulose by the usage of spinneret. Spinneret is something like this. Okay, it is having like tiny holes. Okay, it's like needle holes, whereby rayon solution, okay, in the terms of viscose, will be added here, and then it will be spin out and produce fiber. Okay, so how do they make this rayon viscose? Rayon viscose is the solution, the intermediate solution before a cloth is produced. Okay, we will see on the next slide. Okay, viscose rayon is made by converting the purified cellulose by dissolving it into caustic soda. Okay, caustic soda is like the is actually to shred or to make the cellulose to be soluble and amenable to be transformed into other condition, physical condition, eh? And then regenerated will be emerged from using spinneret, just like before this I showed. Okay, so to make rayon, sheets of purified cellulose, okay, is either coming from any source, okay, will be added in caustic soda for a few hours or few days, and usually is up to 3 days to make sure that it is into something that is like a gooey state. Okay, and then when it's dried, it is shredded to make it churn and into small particles. When it is produced into small particles, crumb, it will be added with carbon disulfide. Later we will look on how carbon disulfide is substituted into the cellulose structure. Okay, in this situation, you will have an orange colored crumb where we call it as sodium cellulose xanthate. So this viscous solution, it looks like honey solution. Okay, remember, so this is in a solid phase, this is liquid phase, like viscous solution, and then when you spin around it, it will produce rayon. Okay, let's look into the reaction scheme of rayon. So this is the starting material of cellulose before regeneration. You add with caustic soda, and then you add with carbon disulfide to make it into orangey solution. Okay, in the polymerization, you can see that you have eliminating 6 molecules of water. So you can predict that this is a condensation polymerization reaction. Okay, you see that on the OH part over here, okay, the hydrogen has been replaced with the disulfide. Okay, the disulfide. So this makes the whole chemical structure amenable to be in liquid solution. Okay, cellulose just now is not in liquid solution, it's only on solid state. Okay, now when disulfide is there, it can yield viscous. Viscous is like the honey solution, orangey type. Okay, after that, what happened? So, in order to turn the viscose into fiber, you have to get rid of this disulfide again. Okay, we don't want it into solution. We don't want it, we want it into fiber state. So you put again disodium sulfate and sulfuric acid, and then you will get back the hydroxyl, just like the original cellulose. This is what we call as regenerated. Sorry, teruk sangat. I don't have the pen. Regenerated cellulose, or we call it as rayon fiber. Okay. Next, we go into cellulose acetate. Okay, cellulose acetate is not regenerated cellulose fiber. It is reformulated. Means that the acetate will be permanently attached to the hydroxyl of the cellulose. Okay, let's see how. The acetate ester is something like this. This is the original cellulose. When acetic acid is added to this cellulose, they attach to it permanently. Okay, that's why we call it as cellulose acetate polymer. Okay, this is the building polymer for cigarettes, for film, sofa, and also spectacles. So when you are having evidence or exhibits from cigarette butt, you can identify the type of the polymer making up the cigarette butt, and then you can identify it whether it's cellulose acetate manufactured from which manufacturer. You can go into database and see. Okay, so let's see how cellulose acetate is produced. Okay, cellulose, coming from this wood, okay, added with the acetic acid, what we call as acetylation. So this is mixed in reactor, whereby the cellulose sheet will be broken into fiber. Okay, into fiber. So for acetylation, other than acetic acid, acetic anhydride is also added. Acetic anhydride is also added, and at the end of the reaction, a solution of cellulose triacetate is obtained at this stage over here. Okay, in a subsequent saponification, or we call it hydrolysis, the solution will be mixed in water into hydrolysis tank, whereby the acetylation is reversed. The reaction is allowed to continue until cellulose 2,5-acetate is obtained. And then it will form precipitation. Precipitates will be formed, and it can be subjected into drying. Okay. And then you can go and make the flakes into certain condition, how do you want to make it into cigarette butts or sheet of paper. So paper over here is the next reformulated example of cellulose fiber. So remember, cellulose is the small, the inner part of the wood, right? So it have a hemicellulose, and then you have lignin. So this is the one that we want. How to get out this one to make paper? Okay, we have extended reaction that we will see later. Okay, so but we have to understand why paper manufacturing is very important to be understood. Okay, paper manufacturing is an example of mass production whereby when it is mass, the variation in terms of design from batch to batch will be really small. Therefore, it's very easy for us to connect this to certain manufacturer, because the individualization of the paper will be easier due to the small variation. Okay. So usually, birch or fir is are used as the source to manufacture paper. Okay, this is cellulose. We will see on the next slide on the extended reaction for paper. First, we have the chemical pulping, whereby the pulp inside the wood, the yellowish one. Okay, we want to get it out, but how we can destroy the lignin out of this? We want to destroy this first. Okay, so you can use a very harsh chemical such as sodium hydroxide and disodium sulfide. So disodium sulfide is very powerful to destroy the lignin out of this wood. After some heating, you will have kraft pulp. Why do we call this kraft pulp? Because the whole process is named after a scientist named Kraft. Okay, so when you have the kraft pulp, this is the one that you want for paper. However, it is in black color, right? Okay, in order to make black colored pulp into white paper that you see nowadays, is we have to bleach it. Okay, just like how we bleach our sugar from brown to white. The bleaching mechanism is actually it destroy the metal part of the pulp, okay, leaving behind carboxyl over here. Okay, so from yellowish or brownish, and we get white. Okay, so last time is they are using chlorinated compound, but now it is been replaced with other bleaching agents such as the ozone or hydrogen peroxide. So this is the original one. You will have the final one after you bleach or deoxidize it.